Alright. What are we up to now? I think I did. Well, I did level up. Combat armor. We're heavy now. And I'll put on some more charm. Open up throw. Give me the script. Speak to the ambassador, okay. Dogs. I got any real money.
One sec, looking you up. Commander Shepard, here with the Alliance military. First time on the Citadel, that about right?
How did you know all that?
I'm the CSEC requisitions officer. I need to make sure our buyers are authorized. So, will you be purchasing anything today, Commander Shepard?
Show me what you've got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Oh, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre? Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
All expensive stuff down there. Can't never get it. I bet you they want you, after you've been out in the galaxy in a while, doing whatever, come back to the Citadel.
In other news, Exogeni Corp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
But it is a long ride. That's probably why everybody complained about it. And here we go.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Treat her well, Commander.
I'll take good care of her, sir.
I know you will, Commander.
What kind of leads do we have?
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Noveria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Noveria. Maybe you can figure out where the conduit is before he does.
Anything else?
We have one more lead. Matriarch Benezia, the other voice in that recording. She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau cluster.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll take care of Saren. You take care of the political fallout.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember, you were a human long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
Yes, Commander?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing. But you're the one who can stop Saren. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need anything.
Alright, let's get going. One thing about these games, you can spend hours just doing dialogue.
Stand by, shore party. Decontamination in progress.
Right, in that fashion. But I gotta get the Paragon right here. I'm buying certain stuff.
Decontamination in progress.
Hey, Fort. I have to check it out.
Heard what happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Saren's out there somewhere, and we're gonna find him.
Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander, 100%. Intercom's open. If you got anything you want to say to the crew, now's the time.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
For too long, our species has stood apart from the others.
Now it's time for us to step up and do our part for the rest of the galaxy. Time to show them what humans are made of.
This began with an attack on a human settlement in the Traverse.
But we know Saren won't stop there. His Geth armies aren't going to stay on the far fringes of Citadel space.
This is the most important mission any of us have ever been on.
The fate of an entire galaxy is at stake. We will stop Saren, no matter what the cost.
Well said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The Captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Yes, sir.
All right. Go talk to everybody.
Anything you need, Commander?
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander? Anything you need, Commander?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
I don't see how we could have done things any better. At least not without getting to Eden Prime sooner. And we were on the scene faster than any other Alliance ship could have been.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
That's one thing about this game. You have to... By the end of the Mass Effect game, you have to talk to your crewmate. Every time you get done with a mission.
Shepard, what can I do for you?
What's your story, Rex?
There's no story. Go ask the Quarian if you want stories.
You Krogan lived for centuries. Don't tell me you haven't had a few interesting adventures.
Well, there was this one time the Turians almost wiped out our entire race. That was fun.
I heard about that. You know, they almost did the same to us.
It's not the same.
It seems pretty much the same to me.
So your people were infected with a genetic mutation? An infection that makes only a few in a thousand children survive birth? And I suppose it's destroying your entire species?
I suppose it isn't all the same.
I don't expect you to understand, but don't compare humanity's fate with the Krogan.
Sorry, Rex. I wasn't trying to get you upset.
Your ignorance doesn't upset me, Shepard. As for the Krogan, I gave up on them long ago. The genophage infected us, but it's not what's killing us.
Are your people really dying?
We're sure not getting any stronger. We're too spread out. None of us are interested in staying in our own system.
Lots of species have left their homes and prospered.
But they go to colonize new worlds. We're not settlers. We're warriors. We want to fight. So we leave. Hire ourselves out. And most of us never go back.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Ask the Salarians if you want details. They made it. All I know, it makes breeding nearly impossible. Thousands die in stillbirth, and most never get that far. Every Krogan is infected, everyone. And no one's rushing to find a cure.
Why don't the Krogan try to find a cure?
When was the last time you saw a Krogan scientist? You ask a Krogan, would he rather find a cure for the genophage or fight for credits? He'll choose fighting every time. It's just who we are, Shepard. I can't change that. Nobody can.
So long, Rex.
Shepard.
Commander?
What's your opinion on the last mission?
Kinda wish you'd got there sooner, Commander. No offense, I appreciate the rescue. I just wish...
You wish we'd been able to save the rest of your unit?
Yes, sir. If I had been more alert, we wouldn't have been cut down by an ambush.
The Geth are perfect ambushers. They don't move, they don't make noise. They don't even breathe.
Sir, they have flashlight heads. I'll make sure it doesn't happen again.
Do you have a few minutes to talk one-on-one?
I'm sorry, Commander. I need to get my duty squared away. I wouldn't mind talking more later, though.
Dismissed, Chief.
Sir.
And on this playthrough, I'm gonna stay true to that. True. See what it does. It's supposed to be something carry on.
Thanks for bringing
all
me
games,
on board, Commander.
So tried.
I knew working with a Spectre would be better than life at CSAC.
Have you worked with a Spectre before?
Well, no, but I know what they're like. Spectres make their own rules. You're free to handle things your way. At C-Sec, you're buried by rules. The damn bureaucrats are always on your back.
Being a Spectre does have its advantages.
Exactly my point. If I'm trying to take down a suspect, it shouldn't matter how I do it, as long as I do it. But C-Sec wants it done their way. Protocol and procedure come first. That's why I left.
So you just quit because you didn't like the way they do things?
There's more to it than that. It didn't start out bad, but as I rose in ranks, I got saddled with more and more red tape. C-Sec's handling of Saren was typical. I just couldn't take it anymore. I hate leaving.
I hope you made the right choice. I'd hate for you to regret it later.
Well, that's sort of why I teamed up with you. It's a chance for me to get off the Citadel, see how things are done outside C-Sec. Either way, I plan to make the most of this. And without C-Sec headquarters looking over my shoulder, well, maybe I can get the job done my way for a change.
As long as you do your job well, you're free to go about your business as you see fit.
Thank you, Commander.
That's the thing what I wanted to say. Okay, one more. One more.
Your ship's amazing, Shepard. I've never seen a drive core like this before. I can't believe you were able to fit it into a ship this small. I'm starting to understand why you humans have been so successful. I had no idea Alliance vessels were so advanced.
The Normandy's a prototype. Cutting-edge technology.
A month ago, I was patching a makeshift fuel line into a converted tug ship in the flotilla. Now, I'm sitting on board one of the most advanced vessels in Citadel space. I have to thank you again for bringing me along. Traveling on a vessel like this is a dream come true for me.
I had no idea you found ship technology so interesting.
It comes with being a Quarian. The migrant fleet is the key to the survival of my people. Ships are our most valuable resource. But we don't have anything like this. We make do with cast-offs and second-hand equipment. We just try to keep them running for as long as we can. Some of the fleet's larger vessels date all the way back to our original flight from the Geth.
I can't believe your fleet's still using ships that are 3 centuries old.
They're constantly being repaired, modified, and refitted. They aren't pretty, but they work. Mostly. We've tried to make ourselves as independent as possible on the flotilla. Grow our own food, mine, and process our own fuel. But some things we just can't make on our own. A patch to maintain the hull integrity requires raw materials we just don't have. That's why our pilgrimages are so important.
Tell me about your people.
Our lives aren't easy. Resources are scarce, and we are constantly on the move. Everything we do must in some way contribute to the continuation of the migrant fleet. There are 17 million Quarians in the flotilla, and each of us relies on the others for survival. The bonds among my people are strong. Unfortunately, we have had to surrender many of the freedoms and civil liberties other species take for granted.
What kind of freedoms?
Well, it's illegal for parents to have more than one child. If our population grows too much, it would strain our resources to their breaking point. Of course, we also can't allow our numbers to become too few. If our population is in decline, the rule against single births is temporarily repealed. In extreme cases of population decline, incentives are even offered to encourage multiple births, though the Conclave hasn't had to take such measures in nearly a century.
That's your government.
The Conclave is our civilian branch of government. Each ship can elect a representative to serve on the Conclave and make decisions that affect the fleet as a whole. On matters that affect an individual ship, however, the captain has the final say. It's a tradition that dates back to the early days, when the fleet was governed by martial law. Fortunately, most captains nowadays are smart enough to have an elected council from their crew to give them advice and guidance.
So the ultimate power rests with elected officials?
In practice, the Conclave and the respective council for each ship tend to set the rules that govern our daily lives. But in theory, we are still under military jurisdiction. The 5 top-ranking military officials in the fleet serve on the Admiralty Board. These 5 have the power to overrule any decision by the Conclave in case of emergency. To do so requires unanimous agreement among the Admiralty. And they can only do this once. After that, the entire board must resign their posts. It's a safeguard that served us well. In nearly 3 centuries, the Admiralty Board has only overruled the Conclave 4 times.
Okay. That it? Yeah, well...
I should go.
See you later.
Okay. That's everything in that. I could probably get down to Pilgrim, too. Why'd they put the button right there? I could've put the button on the back. Well, let's get this adventure underway. Where should we go first? Let's go pick up Liara. She's at. And we're off. Gotcha. Okay, who should I? I'm gonna take Rex with me and Ashley. Do, and I ain't done in a while. Save. Alright, we got some. Okay, we'll give Vessie some more. Assault training. Here with some combat armor. So. Break the floor. That's alright. Combat armor. Okay. Get warp. And we'll put another one on Kroger Battle Master. Alright.
Commander, I'm picking up some strange readings. Really strange, like off the damn charts. It looks like it's coming from an underground complex a few clicks away from the drop zone.
not drug-worthy.
Only a fool punches a gnathak in the mouth. We should sneak around and pull its tail. With that, better shielding. Okay, where is that? Okay. So, rifle combat.
Commander?
Yeah, well, I should well tally with me. I should have brought Tally with me. I'm going for cover, forgot. Might save up here soon when they pass the thing. So. The first time I ever played this, I got killed. How many times I got killed? Getting better. got killed. Hey, how you doing? Have some of that. You want some too? Alright, there you go. You can get some too. I'm a sharing person, I'm tech. Don't charge anything. Look how good I am. Save. Alright, I got some equipment. Alright, let's go back to me. Did I get any new? New. Nothing. Must be armored though. Gotta be armored. Let's see. I'll go with that. Let's go. Whoa.
I've lost shield.
save again. And one thing about this game, you have to save ever so often. First time you fight this right here. Oh my goodness. Yeah, don't make it tough. That right there. That's a lot. Give her that one, cause she's good then, but ain't no text. I'm gonna give her that one right there. I ain't got no Krogan armor, so I'll have to stop somewhere and see if I can buy some. Pick up some armor for gas. All right. About me. What about them?
Negative you don't see me. Commander.
All right.
I dare you to spit over the side.
Dang, I wasted that on them. I didn't want to waste it on them.
Can you hear me out there? I'm trapped. I need help.
Are you okay? What happened to you?
Listen, this thing I'm in is a Prothean security device. I cannot move, so I need you to get me out of it, all right?
We just need to figure some way past this energy field.
It's a Prothean barrier curtain. I knew it would keep me safe from the Geth. When I turned it on, I must have hit something I wasn't supposed to. I was trapped in here. You must get me out, please.
We'll find some way to help you.
There is a control in here that should deactivate this thing. You'll have to find some way past the barrier curtain. That's the tricky part. The defenses cannot be shut off from the outside. I don't know how you'll get in here. Be careful. There is a Krogan with the Geth. They have been trying different ways to get past the barrier.
Sniper, I doubt I got. Yeah, should have brought Tyler with me. I was going for combat. Alright. Trying to figure this code out. Okay. We gotta level up. Okay, let's put Spectre train.
How did you get in here? I didn't think there was any way past the barrier.
We have to get you out of here before more Geth arrive.
Yes, you're right. I've seen enough of them to last a lifetime. That button should shut down my containment field.
Hold on, Commander. Her mother's working with Saren. Can we trust her?
I am not my mother. I don't know why Benezia joined Saren. I don't want anything to do with that Turian bastard.
If she was with Saren, the Geth wouldn't be trying to kill her.
Any idea how we get out of this place?
There is an elevator back in the center of the tower. At least I think it's an elevator. It should take us out of here. Come on! I still cannot believe all this. Why would the Geth come after me? Do you think Benezia's involved?
Saren's looking for the conduit. Think fast, Miss Prothean expert.
The conduit? But I don't know...
What the hell was that?
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
Gonna be close, Skipper.
If I die in here, I'll kill him. Thank you.
We don't have time to deal with this idiot. Charge!
I like your attitude.
Is involved.
Saren's looking for the conduit. Think fast, Miss Prothean expert.
The conduit, but I don't know.
What the hell was that?
These ruins are not stable. That mining laser must have triggered a seismic event. We have to hurry. The whole place is caving in.
Joker, get the Normandy airborne and lock in on my signal. On the double, mister.
Aye, aye, Commander. Secure and away. ETA 8 minutes.
Gonna be close, Skipper.
Yeah.
If I die in here, I'll kill him.
I would get killed. I would get killed doing this part sometime.
Time to deal with this idiot. Charge!
I like your attitude.
Thank you.
Too close, Commander. 10 more seconds, we would have been swimming in molten sulfur. The Normandy isn't equipped to land in exploding volcanoes. They tend to fry our sensors and melt our hull. Just for future reference.
We almost died out there, and your pilot is making jokes?
Joker pulled our asses out of there. I think he's earned the right to a few bad jokes.
I see. It must be a human thing. I don't have a lot of experience dealing with your species, Commander. But I am grateful to you. You saved my life back there, and not just from the volcano. Those Geth would have killed me or dragged me off to Saren.
What did Saren want with you? Do you know something about the conduit?
Only that it was somehow connected to the Prothean extinction. That is my real area of expertise. I have spent the past 50 years trying to figure out what happened to them.
I've got my own theory on why the Protheans disappeared.
With all due respect, Commander, I have heard every theory out there. The problem is finding evidence to support them. The Protheans left remarkably little behind. It is almost as if someone did not want the mystery solved. It is like someone came along after the Protheans were gone and cleansed the galaxy of clues. But here is the incredible part. According to my findings, the Protheans were not the first galactic civilization to mysteriously vanish. This cycle began long before them.
Where'd you come up with this theory? I thought there wasn't any evidence.
I have been working on this for 50 years. I have tracked down every scrap and shred of evidence. Eventually, subtle patterns start to emerge, patterns that hint at the truth. It is difficult to explain to someone else. I cannot point to one specific thing to prove my case. It is more a feeling derived from a half century of dedicated research. But I know I'm right, and eventually I will be able to prove it. There were other civilizations before the Protheans. This cycle has repeated itself many times over.
What cycle? What are you talking about?
The galaxy is built on a cycle of extinction. Each time a great civilization rises up, it is suddenly and violently cast down. Only ruins survive. The Protheans rose up from a single world until their empire spanned the entire galaxy. Yet even they climbed to the top on the remains of those who came before. Their greatest achievements, the mass relays and the Citadel, are based on the technology of those who came before them. And then, like all the other forgotten civilizations throughout galactic history, the Protheans disappeared. I have dedicated my life to figuring out why.
They were wiped out by a race of sentient machines. The Reapers.
The Reapers? But I have never heard of... How do you know this? What evidence do you have?
There was a damaged Prothean beacon on Eden Prime. It burned a vision into my brain. I'm still trying to sort out what it all means.
Visions? Yes, that makes sense. The beacons were designed to transmit information directly into the mind of the user. Finding one that still works is extremely rare. No wonder the Geth attacked Eden Prime. The chance to acquire a working beacon, even a badly damaged one, is worth almost any risk. But the beacons were only programmed to interact with Prothean physiology. Whatever information you received would have been confused, unclear. I am amazed you were able to make sense of it at all. A lesser mind would have been utterly destroyed by the process. You must be remarkably strong-willed, Commander.
Okay, this isn't helping us find Saren or the conduit.
Of course, you are right. I am sorry, my scientific curiosity got the better of me. Unfortunately, I do not have any information that could help you find the conduit or Saren.
I don't know why Saren wanted you out of the picture, but I think we'll be a lot better off if we bring you along.
Thank you, Commander. Saren might come after me again. I cannot think of anywhere safer than here on your ship. And my knowledge of the Protheans might be useful later on.
And her biotics will come in handy when the fighting starts.
Good to have you on the team, Liara.
Thank you, Commander. I am very grateful. Oh, I am afraid I am feeling a bit lightheaded.
When was the last time you ate, or slept? Dr. Chakwa should take a look at you.
It is probably just mental exhaustion, coupled with the shock of discovering the Prothean's true fate.
I need some time to process all this. Still, it could not hurt to be examined by a medical professional. It will give me the chance to think things over. Are we finished here, Commander?
We can talk again after you've seen the doctor. The rest of you, dismissed.
Mission reports are filed, Commander. You want me to patch you through to the Council?
Patch him through, Joker.
Setting up the link now, Commander.
We've received your report, Commander. I understand Dr. Tassoni is on the Normandy.
I assume you're taking the necessary security precautions.
Liara's on our side. The Geth were trying to kill her.
Benezia would never allow Saren to kill her daughter.
Maybe she doesn't know.
Or maybe we don't know her. We never expected she could become a traitor.
At least the mission was a success.
Apart from the utter destruction of a major Prothean ruin. Was that really necessary, Shepard?
The Geth were crawling all over those ruins. We were lucky to make it out alive.
Of course, Commander. The mission must always take priority.
Good luck, Commander. Remember, we are all counting on you.
Alright. Well, that'll be it for the day. We did the Citadel, got the Liara, and when we come back, we'll finish it up. I'll talk to all the crew, and then we'll make our way to Novaria or Pharos.